Hello, everybody. First of all, thank you so very much for being here. Thank you for watching my channel, Ivana Tarot. This is monthly tarot reading, but also astrology reading for astrological sign Cancer for both female and male people all over the world, February 2017. In front of you, you can see this circle astrological chart, and I will use chart also with planets, and I will explain during February which planets basically are in a transition from your first house until your 12th house. After that, I will reshuffle my tarot deck, my tarot cards, and I will make a tarot reading also for every single part of your area in your life, from your for your personality, how you will have opportunity to make your money, sibling, friends, short trips, love, your career, and so on and so on, and etc. So my dear Cancers, before I proceed, let me just remind you, please go also watch your moon sign and your rising sign as well, because believe me, you can get even more further informations about February 2017. So my dear Cancers, I will start with Sun. During February, Sun will be in the sign of Aquarius in your 8th house. So Sun in your 8th house. A little bit later, by the end of February, Sun will move to Pisces, but for majority of February, Sun will stay in the sign of Aquarius in your 8th house. Of course, next to Sun, you also have Mercury, so you can expect during the February some type of news from other people, most likely something about your money. Some of you will get inheritance, some type of legacy, so I do expect that you will hear some basically very good news during the month of February. Also, those news could be very, very good, especially for your partner. Maybe your partner will get a new job or basically a promotion, especially if you are already married, you know, couple, if you are already being, you know, married woman or a man. Okay, this is not all, especially financial situation of your husband or maybe of your wife, depends on your gender, who you are watching now this video. Also could hold some quite very good, you know, news. Something is coming, something is shifting, so basically quite very good position. Also, I can tell you right away, your sexual life is going to be very, 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 very good. Then Jupiter is of course still in your fourth house in a sign of Libra, and Jupiter will stay in a fourth house until middle of October 2017. My dear Capricorn people, inside of your house, regards your whole family, you can expect some quite very, very good informations, maybe even buying a new home, new apartment or something like that. Still, because Jupiter is going to be in a retrograde motion in the month of February, something might be, you know, delayed. If you want to buy something, or basically maybe you already have a house, but there could be some other problem, maybe with your spouse, or maybe with your older, I don't know, some relative or something like that. Could be some type of problem. Maybe you are going to delay moving to a new house. But still, this is not that bad news for you. It is not, because Jupiter will give you a positive outcome, but you need to be patient. But still, having a Jupiter in a sign, in a sign of Libra in your fourth house, it means that especially if you're already in a long-term committed type of relationship, also I can see many, many marriages for at least one group of Cancer people. So do not worry. Jupiter will try to save you in any given problem, if basically if any is going to be in the month of February for you. Saturn, he's still, of course, you most likely know that in a sign of Sagittarius, being placed in your sixth house. Sixth house, this is your house for diet, health, and basically job on everyday basis. Okay, Saturn being placed in your sixth house, he can cause some problems, but only because Saturn is here and now he wants to teach you something. And everybody is still, you know, afraid of planet Saturn. But to tell you the truth, planet Saturn basically is the very best friend of yours. Maybe you have some nasty superior, your main manager or something like that, and you will see that basically not only now, but for through whole 2017, someone is trying to torture you, you know. But this person, whoever this person might be, female or male, this person basically wants to teach you something. This person is not here, you know, and now to torture you, but to teach you something. But everybody hates Saturn, but believe me, this planet is the very best friend that basically you can have in your whole life. But yes, Saturn and influence coming from Saturn could be nasty, could be difficult, could be hard to cope with, but still, believe me, planet Saturn, when he's going to be ready to move to another house, believe me, you will have something, some type of new foundation. Maybe even in 2018 you are going to be ready to fulfill your dream and basically to start with business of your own. But for the time being, you need to be here now, you need to listen to this planet Saturn, meaning most likely your nasty boss or someone who basically you think that this person basically want to torture you. Especially while you have this planet Saturn in your sixth house, many Cancer people, finally you will say, okay, enough, I do not want to eat meat any longer. So maybe you already or basically you might become a vegetarian. Okay, Pluto is still in your seventh house of your marriage, and there is something that you also need to learn. Many Cancer people, you still have so many, you know, doubts, questions, you know, feeling, you know, fear of something, but this is something that basically you need to confront with. Also, Pluto is here and now want to destroy any type of bad relationship. If you are suffering, you do not want maybe to admit that you are suffering in your marriage, believe me, Pluto will force you finally, you know, to say something, to change something in order to have blessed and good quality, positive relationship, not only with your partner, not only with your husband and with your wives, but basically with all people surrounding you. And in your 10th house, in the sign of Aries, you have Venus, Mars and Uranus, everything in your 10th house. So what are doing Venus, Mars and Uranus in your 10th house in the sign of an Aries? They want to give you a specific power, strength to follow your dream, you know. For a couple of years up in front, Uranus will try to little bit, you know, to shake up your prejudice, or maybe there is some kind of dream that basically you want to follow, but maybe you are afraid to start with business of your own, something like that. Maybe not for all of you, but at least for some of you. And while you have Mars and Venus placed in your 10th house in the sign of Aries, basically, or maybe you want to start with a sport of some kind, if you are quite still young, maybe this is your professional, being a soccer player, rugby player, baseball player, Who knows? So basically, there is some kind of agenda inside of you, and now you will have enough of power, you will have enough of strength to follow your dream. To follow your dream. Maybe even some of you, you can become a pretty famous tennis player or something like that. But this is only for one group of Cancer people. But in majority, like in generally speaking, Mars and Venus being in your 10th house, most likely, maybe you are already in love working with your husband or wife, depends on your gender. But also if you're single, inside of your company, whatever you are working just like now, you can start beautiful love relationship. So who knows, maybe, you know, this is, you know, first sparkles, which basically will start from February on. February 11th, we have a full moon in a sign of Leo, which is in your second house. This is your second house, full moon in a sign of Leo. Now, this is a very interesting thing for you. First of all, this is your second house. How you value yourself when it is come of earning money with your two hands, you know, and you will shift something. Something you will finally understand, and you will say to yourself, okay, I am old enough, I am experienced enough, I want to finish something in order basically that you can start with totally something new. For some of you, this could be business related with your family, or at least with one sibling of your own. Some of Cancer people, finally you will allow yourself to work basically for yourself. Don't forget, you still have Jupiter in your fourth house, and basically this is very good. So this is like a final decision which is going to be made by you, kind of, and especially with this Saturn being in your sixth house, you know, sooner or later you will say, okay, enough, I do not want to listen my superior anymore, I want to start with, you know, business, could be little business, but basically you will, at least one group of Cancer people, you will have opportunity to start with something new, because you are experienced, because you are mature, and basically your self-esteem is going to be very, 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 you know, uplifting. And don't forget Venus and Mars giving you a strength and giving you like a courage like never before. February 26th, we have a new moon in your ninth house in a sign of Pisces. Now, this is quite very, very good, good new moon in a sign of Pisces. What that means? It means that you can start love relationship with someone online, but you are going to be very, 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 very interesting all of a sudden in some spiritual question. Now you want to know, now you are ready, any type of information that you can gather about your previous life, and especially during this month, you can start a relationship with a Pisces partner, but also for you can be very important. For you can be very important during the month of February, if you're speaking only in terms of your love relationship, could be Libra, Taurus, Leo, and Sagittarius. This is what I think. But with this placement, new moon in your 10th house, you will start examining and maybe even learning some other language. Because maybe you want to travel, with your family or basically with your partner on some very, very distant, far away country. So this is a little something about astrology. Now I have my tarot deck in my hands. For every single house, I will put for one tarot card. You can hear me shuffling already, my dear Cancers. So then we can learn even much more details in this upcoming month for you. Don't forget, put your comments down below. Okay, first your personality, and this is what I have for you, Major Arcana the Devil. Now, Major Arcana the Devil, this is basically you being determined. You want to earn money, and I'm not talking about one or two hundreds of dollars. This is basically you start thinking like never ever before. I want to earn more money, and this is like final resolution coming from you. Don't forget, you have the full moon in your second house. Don't forget that. But also with Major Arcana the Devil, this could be some old project that once again you will decide, you know, to put in front of you. Could be an old project. Okay, when I'm going to be able to reach seventh house, then I will connect those two opposite tarot cards, first and seventh. And please don't forget, when I'm going to the through whole astrological chart, then I will come back to your seventh house and I will add two additional two tarot cards only for your love relationship during this month of February. Okay, Page of Cups, your second house, how you value yourself and how you value money. This is your Page of Cups because you do belong to water sign. So basically, you have Major Arcana the Devil and you have Page of Cups. Okay, you will understand during the month of February something very, very important. What this might be. I think that many people already use you, especially when it comes to your money situation. Now you will finally understand, especially with this full moon in your second house, nobody will have opportunity to use me like, you know, once again. No one. I think many Cancer people that basically you have problem, you have issue with saying no to people. Believe me, especially with Major Arcana the Devil, during the month of February, you need to learn how to say yes to those people who basically want to use you, especially for money. Okay, Eight of Pentacles, this is your third house, communication, marketing, short trips, and siblings, and basically your friends. Eight of Pentacles, once again, money, once again, money. Because this is everything connected with this having the full moon in your second house. So once again, this is money. Money coming from most likely other people. But also could be, once again, someone can decide, you know, to knock at your door. Oh, you know, I have, you know, problem. Can you, please lend me, borrow me some money. And because you are such a good soul, this is going to be a big, big difficult time for you. How to say no to certain friends or maybe even siblings. How basically, you know, how to say no. But still you have Mercury and you have Sun in your 8th house. You do not worry that much about money of your own. You don't have to worry about that. Especially if you're already like a married person. Because your spouse, he or she will have opportunity to earn basically more money. Okay, we will see more details when I'm going to be able to reach basically your 9th house. Okay, your 4th house, and this is your house. Your home. This is your home. And I have for you King of Wands. Now, if you are already in a relationship with a Leo or maybe an Aries, also could be a Sagittarius, especially with Jupiter being in your 4th house, this could be quite very, very good relationship, maybe even marriage, if you're already married. But if you are like a single with this person, maybe, and this person could be friend of your parents, this person could be friend of your brother or sister, something like that. But anyway, this person might enter into your life. This is very, very enthusiastic type of a person, fiery sign, and very, 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 very sexually, most likely attached to you. Okay, little more details I'm going to be able to reveal for you when I come to house, which basically is the opposite. Now, this is your 5th house. This is a house for your creativity, for love, for also your kids and some other stuff. Okay, 2 of Wands. What 2 of Wands? How we can translate 2 of Wands when it comes to your 5th house? First of all, there is also someone on your mind, and you just can't forget about someone. You just can't forget about someone. Maybe this is Capricorn, maybe this is Taurus, maybe this is Virgo person, and you are still dwelling, you are still staying here and looking kind of a movie of your past, you know, some past relationship, watching movie inside of your thoughts, you know what I mean, past memories and, you know, all these kind of things. And you can see eagle. Can you see eagle? This is news. So someone will call you. If you still expect your ex basically to call you, I think you might have a chance to talk with your ex once again. We will see something a little bit more when I will come to your seventh house. Okay, sixth house. This is your everyday job, and basically this is also your diet and your health house. Ten of Pentacles. This is once again subject about money. Ten of Pentacles. This is big money. This is not small amount of money. This is quite beautiful pile of money. So either way, you will have opportunity. And don't forget, you have Saturn. Maybe because of this Saturn, because of him, because he's not here, I already told you, to punish you. He's here to help you out. So because you have Ten of Pentacles, this is something very, very good, which is concerned about your job. This is big pile of money, maybe even, who knows, especially with such a powerful 10 house, maybe not all of you, but some Cancer people, you will have opportunity all of a sudden basically to be promoted. Why? Because in your 10 house, remember, you have Venus and you have Mars. Okay, your 7th house, 5 of Wands. Now, someone is deeply, maybe still in love with you. This is your ex calling your name in his dreams. Someone who basically owes you an explanation, someone who owes you an apology, or someone basically, you know, who owes you something, someone that basically you treated in a such a good manner, but this person was not that good toward you. Can you see? Major Arcana, the Devil, and 5 of Wands. So basically you treated someone with a love, appreciation, but someone basically spit on you. I think this is your ex, and I think that this ex of yours should stay your ex. This is at least what I think. But there is a kind of obsessive, some kind of feeling between you and that person. You just can't forget about him. Nevertheless, you know, he was not that good to you, but still you are very, very connected. Hopefully, this can't be, you know, applied to every single Cancer, because you are going to suffer because of this person. Maybe even he will try to re-enter into your life, saying some kind of, you know, explanation, or, you know, I'm sorry or something like that. But, you know, you need to wait until I finish whole circus, and then the whole circle, and then I will come back once again. I will take another two tarot cards only for your relationship. 8th house with Sun and Mercury being there. Okay, this is King of Pentacles. This is most likely already your partner. This is Capricorn. This is Taurus. This is Virgo. And I told you, money is coming. Can you see this beautiful chest filled with golden coins? So money is coming. Don't you worry about that. Someone will provide for you. Maybe this is your lover. Maybe this man is your lover. I mean, if you're female Cancer watching this video, then he will provide for you. This is your 8th house. So this is, you know, sexual relationship, or basically money coming from your spouse. The opposite house is Page of Cups. And I already told you that this would be you. And this is, I don't know, this also could be someone new. This could be someone new. And this one is going to be in love with you. This person wants to take care about you, you know. This man is quite very good, solid type of man, and he might fall in love with you. I don't know, he might be your colleague, you know, or someone. I don't know, I mean, could be, you know. Okay, your 11th house, 11th house, and you already know that you have in your 11th house in the sign of Pisces, new moon, King of Swords. Okay, online you can meet someone, Libra, Gemini, or maybe an Aquarius, a person who basically is very, very educated, could be some kind of, I don't know, engineer, but also could be some kind of artist, something like that. And you will communicate a lot with this man. So basically you and this man, maybe, who knows, maybe you will, you know, become, you know, a partner. If this man live in other town, or maybe even in another country, state, or something like that, if he asks you, can you lend me some money in order to visit you, say no. Simply as that. 10th house. Okay. 10th house, which is house of your career, and you already know, I told you, you have Uranus, Mars, and Venus being in your career section. You have major arcana justice or adjustment. So basically there is, you know, some sense of balance. You need to think. So think what basically is the very best course of action for you to take. And I told you, if you watch the whole video, I told you, I explained you what basically is happening in your second house, in a sixth house, and basically now, especially with those three planets being in your career section, you need to make some final decision. Ain't gonna be easy. I can tell you that much. Ain't gonna be easy, because this is justice. This is justice. Whatever, any kind of final decision you are going to make, this decision is going to affect, I don't know, maybe you are chief manager, you know. This final decision is going to affect many, 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 many people. And just look what is the opposite. The opposite is King of Wands. Maybe this is your colleague. Maybe you are already in love with this colleague. So you need to make your final decision. Do you want to be with him? Do you want to sleep with him? Or basically you only want to be a friend with him? To tell you the truth, opposite attraction is going to be so damn high. Excuse me for my language. You just can't say no. Especially if you are single. Especially if you are in a bad marriage without, you know, making love with your husband, there is like almost impossible to say no, because this man is handsome type of guy, very, very handsome type of man. He will seduce you in no time. So there you go, you need to decide. But when it comes only to your career section, only your career section, with this major arcana and basically with those three planets being in your career section, then you need to either say yes or no to this promotion. Ain't gonna be easy, because you need to sacrifice something. You can't have it all, big pile of money, and, you know, for majority of your everyday time, your day spending with your family. So basically you need to decide. Ain't gonna be easy, I can tell you that much. Okay, this is your 11th house, and you have Major Arcana, the Empress. What a beautiful card. I mean, this is art. This is beautiful, beautiful tarot deck. Beautiful, beautiful tarot deck. Watch this lady. Someone very important. If you are male Cancer watching this video, then this would be Libra. For some of you, could be maybe even Pisces. Current female, like a friend, Taurus, Capricorn, or basically someone new that you are going to be able to meet. You will fall in love with your friend. Everything will start with a friendship, but this is very, very stable woman, very, very stable woman. And if you are like a male Cancer watching this video, there you go. Beautiful, 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 beautiful women. Most likely having a kids already, single mom, still very, very beautiful, beautiful woman. And I think many, many, many male Cancers, basically you will fall over heels in love with this woman. If you are a woman, if you are a female Cancer, then this also could be, you know, very, very important female friend for you. You kind of depend on opinion of this person. You are kind of depending. Why? I don't know why, but this person could help you out with many, many questions which basically you have above your head, most likely love question of some kind. And this is Queen of Cups being in your 12th house, being in your 12th house. This is basically behind your back. Now, because this is behind your back and this is Pisces, this is Cancer, this is Scorpio, maybe you are already in a secret relationship with someone. You can't say yes, you can't say no. Most likely you are in love with someone. Someone is in love with you. But in your first house, let me just remind you, you have Major Arcana, the Devil. So those two tarot cards basically are saying, and if you are maybe like almost happily married, you just can't say no to your lover. You just can't say no to him because you are deeply in love with him and most likely vice versa. Now, let me put additional two tarot cards for your seventh house. I told you I'm going to pull. So you have in your seventh house, Five of Wands, Ten of Pentacles and Major Arcana, the Sun. Now, most likely this is your colleague or someone that you already know. This also could be like a friend, like 5 years ago. Then, you know, all of a sudden, you know, he decided, or 5 months ago, you know, he decided basically to approach to you once again if you are, you know, single. Because we have Major Arcana, the Sun, you will fall in love with him and he will fall in love with you with a Nine of Pentacles. I know somehow you are already at least in some level connected with him. Leo, Sagittarius and Aries could be also Capricorn, Taurus or Virgo. So there you go. A lot of informations for you. A lot of informations. Please leave your comments down below. And this is it, my dear Capricorn or Cancer friends. Please subscribe on my channel. Thank you. Like and share this video with your friends. I wish you all the best. God bless. Bye-bye.